Welcome to the Coast to Coast podcast, brought to you by Play Picks and the Lines, coming to you from the West Coast. Josh Lander, joined by my guy Nate Weitzer on the East Coast, and we are looking at our player props video for today on this big Friday night slate. Make sure you are liked and subscribed to that page. You can check out the other couple videos we have, a couple other games on this big slate for you tonight, and check out Nate's great article up on playpicks.com right now with some of those best bets and player props we're about to bring you. And as always, if you do still need a FanDuel or DraftKings account, head to fdpicks.com or dkpicks.com and find those listings in your area, such as these player props that we got for tonight. Nate, let's get into it.
Yeah, main billing here on Friday night is the Bucks at the Nets. Yep. And the Nets are not going to have Kyrie Irving tonight, which means probably more of Kevin Durant. But honestly, it doesn't really matter. Even with Kyrie playing his debut, KD posted a 32% usage rate, had well over 30 points. And in his last eight, you know, mostly without Kyrie, averaging 34.5 points, 8 rebounds, 7 assists with a 35% usage rate. His points rebounds prop at 38.5 seems pretty low given those numbers. It seems even lower when you consider against Milwaukee, against the so-called 1B, 1A best player in the world, he goes off for 40.3 points per game and 12 rebounds per game while playing 43 minutes and posting a 40% usage rate in 4 regular season meetings. Now, that is not counting the 7-game series where he went superhuman and carried a skeleton crew to nearly the Eastern Conference Finals. The numbers took a slight dip there just because of the ridiculous defensive attention he was faced with there. But the point is, if he comes to play, he can obviously fill it up. I mean, or if the Nets need him, he can fill it up, and he's doing it in more than just the points. So I would even look at the 13.5 rebounds assists. I think that's very attainable. We're looking at point Durant at this juncture, and he seemed like a little bit inspired by Kyrie coming back, just getting a little more of the joy back in the game. And I think he will be invigorated to go out there, you know, dual motivation to stick it to the Bucks and to keep his teammate up, maybe try to inspire Kyrie to get the vaccine and come back and play in these games. Milwaukee is coughing up, the 7th most rebounds per game at home and the 7th most rebounds over the last 3. So these boards should be there. And when you're talking about Durant, he's a walking 30-point game. So it's an easy pick.
Yeah, and you know what's interesting is Giannis probably coming back in this one as it looks right now, which kind of makes you actually feel better. You might think, oh well, a defensive player of the year, someone who is, if anybody is capable in the league of slowing down KD, it's Giannis. But I mean, even in those playoff series, we don't see Giannis guard him, and Giannis being in the game means we're getting a ton more points. And I'm looking, you know, at feeling good about an over in this one, looking at like a 125-122 final. So you know, someone's got to score a ton of those points. There's only 2 stars on this team right now when they're playing at home. I think you feel good about that going down for KD, is, you know, as he is pretty much their offense right now. Like you said, no matter who's on the court, his usage rate is near 33-34%. So, you know, there's going to be buckets to be had in this one. So if you like his 38.5 points and rebounds, I love that, because if he gets those 34 points he's been averaging, that's 5 boards for a 7-foot man who's going to get plenty of those. So moving to a guy a lot smaller than KD, but God, I love him this year. Darius Garland. Looking at him to take on a Portland Trailblazers team that is, you know, right up there with the Charlotte Hornets as someone that we target for these player props as soon as we see a team playing against them, as they are that bad on D and they play at a big fast pace and everything. So, you know, I'm looking at for him tonight, his points, rebounds and assists. I know he's a small guy, but first of all, those assists, you know, he's been going crazy. He's actually been getting you know, around 3 to 4 boards as well this year, which is really nice. So, you know, he's averaging enough PRA, and especially in his last 5 the games that he's appeared in, he's averaging 33 points, rebounds and assists combined there. You're talking about a Portland team that is just awful on defense. We know that, you know, they give up the 2nd most assists per game to point guards, and the 2nd most assists per game in general to opponents. They have the worst opponent 3-point percentage, and they also give up the 4th most 3-pointers to their opponents. Darius Garland Garland gets a ton of assists. He gets a lot of buckets from three, averaging about 8 3-point attempts a game this season. And you know, he did miss a few games, but he came back in their last loss to the Grizzlies. That was still a close game because he had 27, four boards and 10 assists in that one in about 36 minutes. And his, you know, his usage rate was at 33%. In that one, when Rubio doesn't play, who we know it sadly is not going to be there this season, that's another indication, you know, this is a guy who's not only going to be playing point guard, who's going to be getting buckets, but he's going to also be getting those assists that might be going to another guy like Rubio. His usage rate jumps in the game that he played without Rubio so far this season from 26% when Rubio plays to about 36% in that one without Rubio that he came back. So, I love a guard who's going against a really bad Portland defense right now, and a guy in Darius Garland who's balling out as a top three point guard in the Eastern Conference right now for sure.
Yeah, he's a top guard, and now he's the only guard that the Cavs are going to be able to rely on with Rubio out, and that usage rate jump is really just the key stat for me. It's a 10% increase. Him putting up 27 points and 10 assists against Memphis, which is an elite defensive team.
Yeah.
In that first game without Rubio tells you all you need to know. You should be able to target Garland for a few games here if his props don't adjust, because he's going to be taking on a bigger role as a scorer and facilitator for Cleveland now that he's without Rubio. And if you didn't mention, the 20 points in a win is very juicy there at plus 200, because we're close to doing a full episode on the Cavs -4 in Portland with no Dame Lillard, CJ McCollum, or Larry Nance or Cody Zeller tonight. So I mean, if you can just juke that and get rid of the spread and say all we need is 20 points from Garland, love the odds there.
Agreed.
There's some great player performance doubles to get with LeBron in the game that we do break down there. We like the Lakers to win tonight. We like LeBron to come out aggressive against a Hawks team that, as we mentioned, the last time he faced them, Solomon Hill rolled up on his ankle, derailed his season, his MVP chances last year. He's certainly not going to be happy about that. And this is a Hawks team that he has handled in the four previous meetings, putting up 29 points and 11 assists per game. His prop right now is 37.5 points and assists. Pretty attainable there. The odds aren't great. So if you do want to have a little fun, maybe juke it. You can get 30 points in a win, which, as Josh says in the episode, that's what LeBron has to do for the Lakers to win these days. That's plus 220. I almost never throw this out there, but for him to come out aggressive and get the first bucket is plus 500. That's a fun little bet there, but something that has a little more statistics behind it. For him to get four threes in a win is plus 420. He's hit at least three threes in six straight games, averaging 4.2 at 44% in that span. And Atlanta is 29th in 3-point D and defensive rating over their last five, also giving up the third most assists per game in that span. So LeBron should be able to do whatever he wants. It's just a question of how he wants to attack this team and how important it is to him to stick it to them after the way that last game ended.
Yeah, no, I mean, I love following you as the revenge doctor, as I call you sometimes, because you understand when players are going to have some extra motivation. I agree. I just don't even think he needs it. I think the motivation he needs right now is that he doesn't want his team to be a sub 500 team. And like you said, I said in the video, he needs to score 30 points these days for them to win, because they're not going to be stopping anybody on defense. And he can't rely on finding open guys to make shots. He doesn't even have an accompanying squad right now that just plays in that sort of style of pacing. There are too many ball stoppers, obviously, with Melo and Russ. So I think he's just sort of decided, I'm going to go ahead and get my points. And honestly, the guy that I'm going to find for my assists is Malik Monk when I'm driving and kicking. So I do like his assists and points combined. But, you know, getting that plus 220 on 30 points in a W, like, that's basically, like I said, if you think they're going to win, which we do, then that almost has to happen. So I feel really good about the odds you get on that one. And I'm going to end with a guy that we both love, and I think a lot of people love, but we don't feel is getting the love from Vegas right now in terms of how they're positioning his props. And that's, DDR, a guy, DeMar DeRozan. who you could make the argument is in the top. No, you can't. You have to make the argument is in the top five of the MVP voting in the league this year. And his points total is at 25.5 right now against a Wizards team that has come crashing back to earth as a really bad defensive team. And, you know, really, regardless of who DeMar is playing right now, the man is just a walking bucket. You know, and when he's played Washington in his last two versus them, including one this season, 32.5 points per game, 49% from the field. And he's getting 11 free throw attempts averaging there. So, you know, what's awesome there for us is watching a guy who does score a ton of his points from the 2-point mid range, which is why Chicago is second in their percentage of their points off a 2-point mid range, is they have a guy like DeMar, but that's a layup for the man. And the fact that he's also now getting into the lane and either creating with guys like Zach LaVine or, you know, getting to the line, like we talk about to this extent, that's why you see his points per game at such a high pace at this point. You know, and really, you know, I think you look at who they don't have still and guys like Lonzo, it allows you to get DeMar in a higher usage rate role, into a place where they're getting him into space, allowing him to work how he wants off of the wing and the elbow, the extended elbow, and then letting Zach LaVine work off of that and get his as well. I'm not even worried about Zach LaVine getting his. I think, you know, I just love the fact that it's DDR against the Wiz, and a team that he's played really well against, a team that's giving up a ton of points in a position that, you know they need to win a pretty crucial conference game. So, yeah, plenty of motivation for DeMar to get his 26 tonight in a place that we think he's still being disrespected, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, because the usage rate is going to be there, especially Lonzo Ball been back one game off the COVID list, and he just went 1-for-8 from the field. He's not even really going to be looking for his offense. He'll be concentrating on his role, slowing down Bradley Beal probably. And the Bulls have a big rest advantage here. They haven't played since Monday when they beat the Magic at home. So they've just been chilling all week, whereas the Wizards had to play and actually lost to Houston and then lost a couple more guys into protocol after that. This is also a Wizards team that sells out to guard the rim, guard the three-point line. And DeMar doesn't do either of that. He's, you know, the only guy in the league who just says, all right, that's fine. I'll just operate here in the mid-range. So, yeah, I think 26 points for him is a very likely scenario.
For sure. We continue to roll on with these player props, my man. We are feeling really good about 2020 so far. Currently sitting at 10-5, I can say confidently. Probably going to be about another two games above 500 in that record after we see these games ending tonight as we record on Thursday night. But I will say that you do want to like and subscribe to the page so you can check out those other couple videos we have for you today. And until we see you next, happy betting.